Hey, how you doing, everybody? Today we're going to take a look at The 33, which was directed by Patricia Riggen and stars Antonio Banderas, Juliette Binoche, Rodrigo Santoro, James Brolin, and Lou Diamond Phillips. This movie is based on the true story of the 2010 mining incident in Copiapó, Chile, when 33 miners were trapped after a cave-in in the San Jose mine and had to survive down there for an amazing 69 days until they were finally rescued, and somehow they all made it out alive just thanks to their experience and determination and just sheer fucking force of will. It really is an amazing story, and a story like this, I suppose it was only a matter of time before someone tried to turn it into a movie, and here we are. It's a movie that honestly wasn't really on my radar. I didn't hear about it until very recently, actually, when I noticed there was a pre-screening available for it. So I decided to check it out because I had the time, and here's what I can say about it. First of all, I thought the acting was pretty solid across the board. I especially thought Antonio Banderas did a very good job as Mario Sepulveda, aka Super Mario, as he came to be known, as he became kind of the official spokesperson for the group. And at least the way this movie portrayed him was really the glue that kind of held everyone together. I don't know if that's actually how it went down in real life, but that's how it is in the movie. For the most part, it is very well shot, and the movie does a very good job of illustrating just how dire the situation was for these men. After this cave-in, when they make it down to the refuge, they find a radio that doesn't work, a first aid kit that's practically empty, food reserves for about 3 days, which they have to stretch out a whole lot longer than that. Oh, I would not wish this on anybody. And as best as I can tell, the movie does stay fairly faithful to the actual events, which is both to its credit and also to its detriment. Good on them for trying their best to tell the real story of what these men went through, but it seems to me that this is a story which is definitely something everyone should hear, but not necessarily the kind of story that translates very well to film. Any conflicts that sprout up between the miners while they're trapped underground are resolved just a little too quickly, and likewise for any conflicts up top between the Chilean government that's working on a rescue and the families of the miners. And because it is kind of tough to tell 33 different stories, most of these miners just kind of get pushed off into the background, and there's only about 4 or 5 of them that get any significant screen time. And if you know the story of the 33, you know that once they hit about the 17-day mark, that's when they were finally able to drill down into the refuge and confirm that, in fact, all 33 of them were still alive and well, or as well as they could have been, given the circumstances. And when that moment finally happens in the movie, that really feels like it should be the climax. Like, these poor, poor men have been in these dire circumstances for over 2 weeks, and finally their savior has arrived, and it just feels like this should be the finish right here. But this is only the beginning. There's still about a half hour left to go in the movie after this point, because drilling that hole down there was only step one. Now they have a way to contact them, and they can get food and supplies down to them and keep them alive, but they still have to find a way to actually get them out, which involves drilling an even bigger hole that they can actually fit through, and they have to find a way to do this without causing a further cave-in, because the mine is already very unstable. Obviously, that's how the cave-in happened in the first place. And it just really makes the movie feel way too long, even though it's not really all that long. It's just a hair over the 2-hour mark, but yeah, it's just, it's a story that doesn't translate very well to film. One really weird thing that I noticed in this movie, they made the decision to have pretty much everyone speak English, which, you know, is fine, even though this is all taking place in a Spanish-speaking country. It's made for an English-speaking audience primarily, so, okay, you want to have everyone speak English, fine. But there are one or two people who still speak Spanish in this movie. Like, when a Spanish-speaking media personality, I think his name is Don Francisco, when he shows up, he only speaks in Spanish. And I don't know if that was a conscious decision on their part, or whether it's simply because he doesn't speak enough English and just that was the only option. but it felt really weird. In a way, it kind of reminded me of the American broadcast of the Japanese show Iron Chef, where the chairman still had his original voice and was subtitled, but everyone else was dubbed in English. It's just, it seemed a bit odd, really. And while this movie does do a fairly good job of sticking to the real story of what happened to these men, it is not above the tropes. Oh no. The boss of the San Jose mine, for example, this guy. Oh my god. When the foreman, played by Lou Diamond Phillips, is talking to this guy about how he suspects the mine may not be safe and there's a risk of a cave-in and this and that, he is having none of it, and he just tells him straight out, I do not give a shit about your safety. You are going to go down there and get to work, and not only that, but I am demanding that you increase your output to a ridiculous level that you can never possibly hope to achieve, just because I can. Now get to work. I have to spend my days sitting in my office and twirling my mustache. Okay, he wasn't quite that bad, but still, this guy is such a cartoon villain, and, you know, I heard stories about how the safety warnings from the miners were largely ignored by the people in charge, and I have no reason to doubt that. That seems to be a common thing in the mining industry, sadly, but surely there was a better way to convey this without making this guy look like such a stereotypical villain. There had to be a better way. Had to. Also, and this was a moment where I really just went, come on, no. The oldest miner in the group, would you believe it? He was just 2 weeks away from retirement. I'm not making this up, they actually do this. 2 weeks away from retirement, exactly. Oh my god. Really? As soon as I saw that, I just thought, no, that can't be right. That is just way too perfect. There is no possible way. So I looked it up, and turns out, no, it is not accurate as far as I can tell. But like any good lie, it does have just a hint of truth to it. Turns out this guy, I believe his name was Mario Gomez, not the same Super Mario, different Mario. It was a common name, apparently. He was at least contemplating retirement a few months down the road. But it was not set in stone, and it was not 2 weeks away. I cannot fucking believe they did that. That is, oh, no. Bad movie. Shame on you. In the end, the movie is okay, I suppose. It's just not nearly as compelling as it really should have been given the events that inspired it. Probably still worth watching, but not really worth spending your money to see it on the big screen. I would say wait for rental for this one. Really, if you want to see a movie in theaters about someone surviving a horrible accident despite impossible odds, you should really just go see The Martian again. And that about does it for the 33. So until next time, take care.